Hello everyone, how are you? I'm Luciana, this is my YouTube channel 24 Horses Per Second, and today I'm gonna show you how to actually bake materials in Blender into an image texture successfully. I'm gonna bake the diffuse or base color and the sheen as well, but you could use this technique with other attributes. When I tried to do it, I ended up with a black image or with an image that didn't look like my material, just like these examples. This is how my image should look after baking, but it doesn't. So let's fix that. Okay, so here I have two cubes with the same material and with similar lighting to later compare the original texture with the baked texture we are about to make. Let's choose Cycles, CPU, and keep the samples low. I'm not gonna cover UV unwrapping, but go unwrap your model, don't be lazy. First, we're gonna make the base color, also known as diffuse or albedo. Here's how my first attempt for baking looked like. You saw that in the intro, and if you connect the first node to the viewer node, you'll see that the baked texture doesn't look anything like it should. Create a new image texture and choose the name and size of the texture we're about to bake. I'm gonna open the new texture in the image editor to visualize it. Open the bake settings. Choose diffuse. You can change the margin settings if you like. Disable direct and indirect lighting, because we don't want this lighting we have in our scene to be baked into the texture with all these shadows on the sides. Add a diffuse PSDF node and plug the base color nodes into this one. Plug the output. Now select the object and the image texture node we've created and bake. And behold our diffuse image texture. Save it. Let's connect our viewer node to check how similar it looks, and I will say that the baking worked out fine. Now the sheen, which should look like this, but it turned out like this. So how to bake sheen or other attributes as well? Two ways worked out for me. Create a new image texture, name it, don't forget to change the color space. For the diffuse, sRGB was fine, but for the sheen, let's choose non-color. Plug in the nodes onto the emission. Now select the object and the image texture node we've created and bake. Save. Now the second way of baking the sheen. So make a new image texture. Plug the nodes into the diffuse VSDF. Now select the object and the image texture node we've created. and bake. Save it. And as you can see, the two SHEEN baked images look the same with those two different methods. Now, how to set up our baked images? Gonna make a new material for one of the cubes only so we can compare them. We need our principal BSDF, a texture coordinate, and a mapping node, and our image textures. Remember to use the UV socket in the texture coordinate node. As you can see, even the spots are in the same place in both objects. And that's it. I used this method for baking my textures, so I could upload my model to Sketchfab. And I hope this video helped you as it helped me. As always, if you came this far, thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye.